One of the most powerful ways to use Rust is to dive into using things like pre-trained models, using GPU, building high-performance command line tools that you can do batch-based machine learning inference against. What I'm going to show you is how simple it is to use GitHub Codespaces with a GPU, enable that GPU, build up the Rust bindings for it, and take a translation tool and build it out in just a few minutes. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. Here I've got a repo, Nogi BJJ Rust PyTorch GPU template that has all the things you need to get GPUs cooking in Codespaces. And what I'm going to take a look at here is the diagram of what we're going to build. So to start with, you have a CUDA GPU enabled in Codespaces, and then I'm going to go through and use the Rust bindings for Hugging Face. Again, Rust is a high performance language that allows you to build very performant tools. And then we're going to put that together and use it to enable Rust and GPU plus Hugging Face to translate a song that's in Spanish to English. And it actually happens in a very short amount of time, just a few seconds. And we're also able to see that the GPU is being utilized. So really, this is the dream scenario for many people that want to build batch-based machine learning tools. Rust plus a GPU plus Hugging Face is a great solution. So let's go ahead and take a look at the crate real quick. You can see here it's Rust BERT, ready to use NLP pipeline. It takes advantage of the pre-existing PyTorch Rust bindings here, and we're able to actually use that. So let's go ahead and dive in. I'm gonna go ahead and go to this environment and launch a Codespace. All right, once we go through here and launch this Codespace, first I'm gonna show you the code, and then we'll go through and run the code. So to start with, it's actually pretty straightforward to interface with Hugging Face in a GPU. A few things to point out when you first get started is that it's a good idea to actually be able to monitor the GPU. So how would you do that? Well, one of the ways that you want to take a look at the GPU is run NVIDIA-SMI-L1, right? This shows us if there's anything going on. There's nothing going on with the GPU. So when we do actually do the inference, that's actually the step that we're going to take. The other thing that we'll need to do is go over to a repo that I've set up here called Translate. And if I go ahead and I cd into Translate, let's go ahead and walk through the code here. So first up, we have the cargo2ml. Here we have just three dependencies. First, I use those Rust BERT bindings. Second, I use a command line tool. And then third, I use this library called Anyhow. So fairly straightforward. And this is the namespace that I'm gonna work with. Again, when I build out tools, typically I like to build out things with a lib and a main. The main is the command line tool, and the lib is where I do all the work. Let's go ahead and take a look at how this work is actually processed. The first thing I do is I go through here and I say a library that uses Hugging Face to translate text. Here's where I use Rust BERT. And then I build a function that allows me to read a file and return back a string, right? Pretty straightforward, something you do in Python as well. Then I build another function that reads a file and returns an array of lines of the file. And you can see here that the reason for this is that we want to pass an array, which is like a list in Python, into the translator. Now, the final piece is quite simple. We just build a function and I expose it via pub right here so that the command line tool can get access to it. And I say, okay, let's go ahead and build this translator. Let's go ahead and say that the source language is going to be Spanish and the destination language is going to be English. We obviously could build a more sophisticated tool that could accept different kinds of language models, but just to make things simple, we're going to do this. And then I go ahead and I create the model. Then I create a text here, which is a vector of strings, and then I pass in the text to the model. And what's nice about this, again, this uses this function over here, is that I'm able to actually print out what all the sentences are. If we go over to the main here, very straightforward. Again, a pattern I like to use over and over again is I use this command line parser and I map the functions inside my library to subcommands. I have a translation command, I have a print command. To tee it all together, we just go through and we call it, right? So this is a powerful, powerful pattern to use. And then if we want to look at the text here inside, we'll have some lyrics. These are the lyrics to a popular Spanish song from Mana. All right, how do I get this thing running? Pretty easy. all I got to do is invoke whatever is appearing right here. So I can go ahead and say cargo run --- help. This is how I first kind of kick the tires here and get things cooking. What this will do is go through and invoke it and show us what the subcommands are. Now, the part that I think is going to be fun is let's go ahead and go back to the Bash terminal here, and let's actually go through and do NVIDIA SMI-L1. And this is going to show us whether our tool is able to utilize the GPU. So let's go ahead and run it, and let's actually go through and see if I put in the path to the lyrics, how long it takes. Okay, it's going through, it's invoking. We see, in fact, it is using the CPU, the GPU, and it ran in just a few seconds. We're able to translate a document. So this really shows you the power of why it's so important to use the Hugging Face plus Rust plus GPU combo. You can build batch-based tools that really are gonna run circles around interpreted languages like Python.